to show you how to construct the union of two finite automaton. And what does union mean? That means we want to get a new automaton which accepts any word that is either accepted by the first automaton or the second one, or maybe even by both. And how do we do that? Well, it's very easy. We take those two automaton and we add a new start state. Let's call it Q0 new or something. Let's make it an initial state. These two won't be initial states anymore. And of course we would have to rename the states, because we are not allowed to have two states with the same name in one automaton. But that's not important for my explanation. So we create those new initial states. And from those initial states, we add transitions to every one of the previous initial states with an epsilon. And, well, that's it. Now we have a new non-deterministic automaton which accepts the union of the languages of those both automaton. And if we want to have a deterministic automaton that accepts the same language, then we can just remove the epsilon and make it deterministic, which I show you in other videos. And, well, a small note, a union of those languages is also denoted as this one. So this is the language of our initial first automaton, and that's the language of our initial second automaton, and the union of those both, that is the language of our new automaton, which we just created here.